completed the MSc post graduation from the BM Patil Medical College, Vijaypur. And madam completed the MCH from the Bangalore Institute of Medical College. And madam started the service from the BMD Medical College, BM Patil Medical College. And now madam is Civil Hospital as a pediatric surgeon. And madam published the so many articles and given the so many guest lectures. And by this short short introduction, I welcome you, madam.
Be attentive and interact in the session.
Evaporation is a part of liquid. It's like a sweat, which is which is circulated from the body surface area of the child. These are the three major causes of weight loss in the children, and one is the conduction, which is based on what it is seen in the under surface of the body. The newborn children usually have less fat. There is one more fat called as brown fat, which is mostly accumulated in these parts.
Yeah,
gestational age, if the child is 10% lower than the 2.5 kg, above the normal, if it is more than 90%, plasma gestational age child is usually the mothers are hypothyroidism or the diabetes mellitus, the child will be more than 4.5 kg to 4 kg weight. If the child falls around 2.5 to 3.5 kg, if for Indian scenario, it is normal. Coming to normal measurements of the child in the newborn period. Normal length will be around 48 to 52 centimeters. When you see for the rump heel length, from the vertex to the heel, if you measure, it will be around 48 to 52 centimeters normally in the Indian scenario. Head circumference would be around 30 to 36 centimeters. If more than 36 centimeters gradually increases, then we call it as a hypothyroidism, where there will be the fluid accumulation in the brain matter. 36 centimeters is normal. We should be again measured right above the eyebrows of the child. There are certain points where you have to examine the head circumference of the child. Just above the eyebrows, if you see that for the child, any newborn patient, will give the parameter of 32 to 36 centimeters in this one. If there is less than 32 centimeters, then we call it as a microsomia. Chest circumference should be examined at the level of the nipple line. There are nipples are there, you should examine there. Then there will be normally 30 to 34 centimeters. This is not an important parameter in a newborn period. Normal length, normal weight, and the head circumference should be normal, and the child is active. Chest circumference will not give us tightness significance in a newborn period. Coming to vital signs. First, we check for temperature. Temperature usually you take at the armpit or the rectal temperature or the dorsum of the tongue, where we can see there will be normally 36.5 to 37.5 normal temperature in the newborn. Anything which is less than 36.5 temperature, then newborn period, which is hypothermic. Again, more than 37.5 should be clearly monitored, because the child may go for convulsions or it may go for gynecological bleeding. Pulse rate usually the newborn should be having 120 to 160 beats per minute. If the child is not crying, if the child is very calmly placed on a former or a mother's lap. If it is more than 160 of beats per minute, the child will be having fever or a hypoglycemia, low glucose levels in the body, or it may be a sepsis child. Less than 110 or 120 indicates the child is having some cardiogenic abnormalities. Respirations, normally the newborn respirations will be higher, because the transition from the fetus to the newborn, so initially the child will be not taking any breaths in the womb. Once it comes out after birth, the respiration starts, usually it will be 30 to 36 per minute, 30 to 60 per minute. Anything which is 60 has chest abnormalities. Less than 30 usually there. BP should be examined in a preterm child, because the child has less renal development and the cardia is not well developed in children. So blood pressure has to be monitored in a patient with preterm or a child with renal or cardiogenic abnormalities. Coming to examination of the fontanelles. This is a frontal bone, this is a parietal bone, and this is back one is the occipital bone. Anything, this is called as anterior frontal elevator. Two frontal bone and the two parietal bones fused. It forms a triangular diamond shaped concavity in the vertex. That is called as anterior frontal elevator. Here the occipital bone and the parietal bone fused in the posterior region forms the posterior frontal elevator. Anterior frontal elevator is very much of significance, because any fluid accumulation in the brain matter or in the ventricles can cause dilatation or bulge in the anterior frontal elevator. As you can see, there is bulge in the frontal elevator, it will be fluid accumulation secondary to hydrocephalus. This is a posterior frontal elevator which is smaller in size. It usually fuses by 3 to 4 months, and this one fuses by 6 to 9 months of the age. Some of the abnormalities which we can see in the newborn period is molding, commonly seen because of long term pressure delivery. Here the bones over and the child can be treated conservatively. There is no surgical intervention needed at the child at the modeling. The modeling will settle by 1 week or 10 days. There will be teeth collection in the, there is a fluid collection in the subcutaneous layers of scalp region that can be treated very conservatively. The next thing which we can see post normal delivery is the soft tissue edema from the birth trauma. Soft tissue edema will be seen all over the occipital parietal region here. It will be subcutaneous collection of the fluid again in the subcutaneous tissue that will cross the suture line and cause edema in the scalp region. This is also treated conservatively. Coming to serpent hematoma. Serpent hematoma, as you can see, there is swelling in the subperiosteal plane. The scalp is, this is the skin, subcutaneous tissue. There is periosteal bone is there. From beneath the bone, there will be accumulation of blood and edema fluid. This is, this doesn't causes the suture line. Well, as the capsule subcutaneum, this is capsule subcutaneum constriction. That is showing causes the suture line. Well, as the second one, serpent hematoma, doesn't cause the suture line. Serpent hematoma can be treated conservatively if it is in the initial picture. The once the child develops jaundice and its secondary infection causes the first matter in the subperiosteal region, then you have to drain the fluid. Coming to examination of the skin, usually normal skin is reddish or pinkish in color. If you palpate the skin is very smooth and puffy in nature. Edema will be due to retained amniotic fluid around the child. The child will be edematous in the first 24 to 48 hours. Then the edema releases, then the skin wrinkles. Tugger is normal. The cord is normal in position, should be around 3 to 4 centimeters in length. It will be usually fall off by 7 to 10 days in the postnatal period. Nails should be very much fragile and bitter in the newborn period. Coming to any abnormalities of the skin can cause underlying diseases. This is called acrocyanosis. First picture, acrocyanosis means there is only the color change in the pedal aspects, color change in the foot and color change in the upper limbs. This is called as acrocyanosis. This is due to pathogenic factors which is not developed in the children. Mottling is due to sepsis because of constriction of the blood vessels in the children. There is patchy opacity and patchy reddening over the all over the body aspect of the child. This indicates the child is sepsis or is having poor circulation in the skin. If the child looks very much yellowish in color, then there will be jaundice. Physiological jaundice usually develops after 24 to 48 hours of the life. Coming to physiological jaundice, which is due to secondary to hyperbilirubinemia. Hyperbilirubinemia is due to increase indirect bilirubin levels in the blood, secondary to hemolytic disease or any liver pathology in the children. Jaundice that appears in the newborn period is pathological. Anything jaundice which is develops after 24 hours of gestation, then it is physiological jaundice. Usually, at the third day of life, it increases to around 10 to 15 milligrams per day bilirubin levels. If more than 15 milligrams develops, then the child will have underlying liver abnormalities and you have to go for phototherapy, blue light therapy, which we usually for physiological jaundice. Anything which is pathological that usually does not settle after 1 week, after 5 to 7 days also it is not developing a decrease in bilirubin levels, then you should go for investigation the child because of liver abnormalities. Coming to newborn examination, this is a whitish thing which is covered all over the body due to amniotic fluid. This is called as vermix. And the postnatal child will be having vesicle like things, spotty, whitish, spotted things over the nose and the chin area. This is called as milia. Laniga is a small hairy things which are developed on the skin. These hairy things will go off as the child ages. Mottling is again bluish discoloration of the skin over the periphery. Second is the vessel constriction. Coming to Mongolian spots, normally Mongolian spots are non-pathological. It is the bluish, grayish patches over the back, nothing pathological. Erythema toxicum is a cephalococcus infection of the skin where the child develops patchy reddish areas all over the body. This has to be treated with IV antibiotics and